Hey guys, glad you could make it. In this episode, we are going to be talking about a very classic fragrance. P.S. by Paul Sebastian. Stay tuned.
How's it going, guys? Hope you're all doing really well today. If you haven't checked out the last episode, I did Bajan for Men, a very classic fragrance. I really like that one. Check it out by getting below. Hope you enjoy it. And in this video, we're going to be talking about another classic scent. This is a scent that came out in the year 1979, and this is one of the fragrances which I purchased while staying in America. 1979, this scent was launched, and I compare this scent to a very famous fragrance, which I'll get to when we talk about the smell. But for now, let's talk about the bottle design. This gets so much hate. I've looked on base notes for Grantica, and people say that the bottle design is ridiculous. I don't think it's too bad, apart from when you take this off, you get this huge atomizer. And I've got a bit of a story to tell you guys, actually, about this. When I first purchased it, it was leaking. It actually leaked all over my hand, and my hands reeked of this stuff. Not necessarily a bad thing, but when you're sat in a car with people who don't really like strong scents, my girlfriend and her aunt, you know, there's a bit of a problem. But this actually comes off, and, well, not that bit, but yeah, this bit comes off here, and you can use this fragrance as a splash, but I'd rather not. But the spray is actually really good, so let's spray it. Sprays very well. I think that this is a very, very good fragrance. I bought this from Marshall's. I paid around, Marshall's is a department store in America, and I paid around $9 for this. Sorry, $9 for this, and this is 125 mil. Decent size bottle, and it's a very decent price. So, let's talk about the smell. Here we go. Okay. So straight away, what I get from the top of the fragrance, I get this very kind of smooth tobacco kind of caramel smell. But the tobacco, I mean, I don't even know if this fragrance has tobacco in it, but this is what I detect. I detect a very smooth tobacco. It's actually very nice. I'm also getting a lot of sandalwood, and I'm also getting a lot of, it kind of smells a little bit like honey. Or it could be vanilla or something like that. Overall, I think that this is actually a very nice fragrance because it has a lot of sweetness to it. And I just think it's very well blended. Now, I'm going to grab a fragrance from my cabinet because this fragrance actually reminds me of this. So, here we go. Not exactly the same, but it is very, very similar. Yeah. Calvin Klein Obsession. I don't know what it is. I just think that they smell very, very similar. I think this is much sweeter, and Obsession is much more, yeah, it's definitely a little bit spicier, but if I had to pick a favorite out of the two, I would say Obsession by a long run. I just think it's much more of a classic, and I do prefer it because I get more longevity out of this, but I do think that they are very similar. They definitely fall under the same genre. But I still think Paul Sebastian, I still think that this fragrance is worth having in your collection. If you're into fragrances and you love, kind of vintage, old fragrances, then this is one you should not, ignore, because I actually ignored this fragrance for a long time when I was in the States, and, I don't know why, I looked at it and I thought, it's gonna be generic, it's gonna be a generic spicy scent, it's gonna smell very old. It's not going to be worth it. But the reason I got this is because it was only $10. And I'll tell you something, guys, I'm so happy with this scent because it just smells amazing and the longevity is very, very good. I get about 9 hours out of this, whereas with Obsession, for example, I get about 12. So this is very, very good. I wouldn't call it a powerhouse scent. I think it's a little bit too subtle to be a powerhouse scent, but if you will smell this for the first time, you will be like, wow, that's a strong smell. It is pungent, so you need to go easy on the sprayer. Maybe one spray on the neck, maybe even two you can get away with. You should be good to go. But I think overall, this is a genuine fragrance. You should definitely not ignore it. It's got some positive reviews online as well, guys. Fragrantica especially. So if you guys want to check out the reviews on there, I'll leave a link for you guys below. So I think that this fragrance is great. Now, let's give it 10 minutes on my skin and I'll get back to you. Okay, so the fragrance has been on my skin for roughly about 15 minutes. So let's try it. Okay, so straight away, I'm already getting something different. I'm still getting that sweet sort of caramel sort of vibe. The tobacco is much more, what's the word? It's not as sharp as it was. I think it's definitely mellowed down. But overall now, I'm getting a very sweet, musky scent. It's really, really nice. This is certainly a fragrance you need to wear with a suit and tie. Well, okay, oh, you guys, I've got to show you my tie. Do you like it? I got it from a antique store because I'm really into the 80s and I really like that kind of design. So yeah, hope you guys like it. Hope you guys don't think I look like a freak. But yeah, I think this is a definite fragrance to wear with a suit. It's perfect. Because now I like this scent even more than I did when I first sprayed it. It's very sweet, subtle. It's actually quite balmy. And what I mean by balmy, it actually smells like a skin cream. So it smells very, very nice. It just sits to the skin really well. So yeah, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this review. This has been for PS by Paul Sebastian. Came out in 1979. And it's a very refined, spicy, sort of musky tobacco fragrance. You know, you can actually subscribe right here by clicking the little icon. So guys, thank you very much for watching this episode. Please like and subscribe, like I said, and keep smelling good. Take care yourselves. Bye-bye.